Hey, Live for Life guys, thanks for joining us again on our Moby Build 2001 Bluebird Schoolie flat nose all-American school bus. Last video we did some framing on the boys bunks as well as the bathroom area. This one you're gonna see a little bit more framing on the bathroom because figured out how we're gonna do the ceiling as well. We're gonna go ahead and do some 110 wiring for outlets and install boxes and switches and stuff like that. Not install switches, but install switch boxes. And then also we're going to fix the 12 volt wiring. I came up with a different idea here. Also you'll see in the video the way we mount them to the horizontal little 1x3 furring strips that I put in there. It's going to help us when we go to spray foam because the wires are going to be exactly where they need to be for where the lights are going to go. So we spray foam, but we're not going to have to pull them over and everything while the foam's drying. They're just going to be right where they're at, which should work out pretty good. We also, in this video, we found an air leak. You got to see where that is. That's in the video. It's actually, I'll tell you, it's up near the driver's console, but where we found the air leak's pretty funny. Had to pull the whole dash out to try to figure out where that air leak was. And then we're also going to frame in the front wheel wells. We ended up using, they were 2x10s, which is just with the height of our floor. The 2x10s were just about an inch above the top of the wheel well, so that worked out well. And all this stuff that we're doing here is preparation for when we go to spray foam. One other thing we did in the bathroom you'll see in the video is we relocated one of the window that where we had built the shower stall. We didn't want a window there because we didn't want water pouring down and going behind the trim and all that. So Kai helped me. We pulled the window out. We pulled the steel plate that we had beside it, moved, basically switched them, resealed everything. Thanks for watching Live for Life and the Moby Build here. Guys, if you have comments, questions, concerns, please feel free to either contact me, hit us up on our Instagram or Facebook, or if you've got my personal phone number, go ahead and give me a call or shoot me a message. Yep, so without further ado, guys, we're going to go ahead and kick it off. Thanks for watching.
So here we are, day one. We're roughing in these electric boxes. We're running them every other window and at about a 48 inch height above the floor. We have roughly 5 plugs on each of these circuits. Should be fine. We're running a 12-2 wire, so pretty thick. We're fishing them through voids we have in the framing on the walls. You'll see here in just a bit, we actually cut some tubing that we had, and anywhere the wire penetrated the metal frame, we would slide a sleeve of that tubing over it so that if we had any friction, there we are cutting it, it wouldn't be a problem. Triton did all the knockouts. He measured some of the wires and cut them, and we fished them through the back of all these outlets. And this is rough wiring, so we may end up changing after a while. Here's the back of the bus running some more 12 volts plugs. Could have some next to the bed, beside the bed. I'm gonna run a plug with a switch right on it so I can have control some lighting in the bedroom itself. Also redoing the 12 volt wiring in the back bedroom there. The 12 volt for the lights in the bedroom, the bathroom, and the bunks are all going to share the same circuit, which is going to be only 6 lights, so it shouldn't be a problem at 4 watts apiece. Here you can see me fixing the 12 volt wiring overhead. You see the boards I've got perpendicular to the furring strips that are ran lengthwise in the bus. And then I secure the wiring and I loop it and hang it down so that when we spray foam, the wire will be readily available for us to just snip and plug in our lights into it. Running some switches and outlets for a bathroom. Tried and did get into the bed area and laid there, and we figured out where we were going to put plugs in the beds, where we were going to have switches and such. I did reframe the ceiling in the bathroom. So we'll have a little shelf above between the ceiling of the bus and the ceiling, or I guess that would be considered the roof of the bathroom. Doing some fractions and math with Triton there. And we're framing in the little fuel fill port, and that'll be spray foamed later. So heading to that front circuit, the bus, redoing all that wiring. So basically we ended what we did. Came up with a new design, roughly cut about 20 feet of wiring out of each of the circuits. So quite a big change there. So you can see me taping up all that stuff over there on the right side of the bus. That's going to be where a bunch of switches are coming to and power for the living room, three-way switches and such. So in the bathroom, we moved this window. This window is actually, you'll see in just a second, it's right inside the shower stall. So we didn't want that window there. So we just moved it over to the right there. And then we moved that steel plate over to the left. And bada bing, bada boom, we drilled it. Kai's on the outside riveting. I'm holding it for him. And then we switch, and he does the same for me. We reseal it, and it's good to go. Kai's getting his workout there. He's wearing his muscle shirt. As you can tell, he's really into this. That's the mineral spirits we used to wipe off the caulking on the outside. We cleaned the windows, resealed them. Had to remove some of the framing we did. We'll just come back and add that here, and I'll toe screw those in here a little bit later. What I'm doing there is trimming some butyl tape. We're gonna line the window with that. Don't forget to like and share. Throwing some more caulking in there. The window should be good to go. We're supposed to be getting rain in a few days, so we'll be able to double check. I'm on the outside ceiling. Kai's on the inside giving me some rags with some of that mineral spirits on there. Big help. So most of the work we've been doing has been in the afternoons because it's been so cool, or sorry, it's been so hot midday and late morning. So we wait till the sun hides behind the building, roughly about 5 in the afternoon. So this was fun. Removed all these screws, pulled the panel out, looking for an air leak. Got to see how things were connected back there and everything as well. So I couldn't find any obvious signs, so I figured, I might as well go ahead and start the bus. Let the pressure build and then see if I can find the leak. Because when the pressure builds, the leak is pretty strong. It's pulling a lot of air. It's just hard to figure out right exactly where it is. So I was actually able to find out where it was. Once the pressure built, it was coming out of... the air suspension seat. One of the lines that was cut, actually both lines were cut, this suspension seat doesn't work. I think it was going to replace it, which is what I need to do. So we're doing here one afternoon, just trying to figure out some measurements so we can figure out the lengths of boards we're going to need. We're going to have to go to the hardware store. Nice little oscillating tool. I don't know what I did without that. So this is second day doing these wheel wells here. Got some 2x10s and mitered some cuts there at 22.5 degrees. And guys helping me put things together.
So this list of things we have to do, I basically, you know, put it here on some legal paper to make it legal. I've got the Mobi to-do list, and I'll kind of read it off to you guys. We did some of it already this last week in the video here. But it says, before spray foam, take photos before I spray. So that's one thing I want to do, is I want to go through and snap a bunch of still photos of all the wiring, everything prior to spray foaming. Where the wiring is, where the water lines are, in case, you know, they're behind the, once they're behind the walls, that way I know exactly where they're at if I go to drill later or anything like that. Move window bath, we did that. I have a question mark here. Move window for Kai's bed. The top bed bunk's got that window still there. It's going to be halfway covered with the mattress when we get the bed in there. And I'm talking to Kai, he said just leave the window. I mean, he said it'd be kind of cool. He can open up the window at night and get to let some cool air in. It's not big enough for him to sneak out at night, so that's going to be good. I'm going to reinforce the windows with angle iron. The windows are riveted on the vertical sections of it, but the horizontal ways, they're really not mounted, so I'm going to put some angle iron that I've got cut up, probably some, see if I can find some old bed frames or something like that and cut some up and reuse some of that material. Reinforce and brace the metal for the front and the back, so where the lift was done. I'm gonna add some more structural framing on the inside. I've got a list of metal that I've got to go pick up at the steel shop, and then I'm gonna cut it in. And I've got a welder, a 220 welder that I fabricated some plugs for, so I can use them. I'll show you guys about that. I'm gonna rough in the water lines. I've got that on the list here as well. Reinforce for awning mounts. Want to get an awning on the outside on the where the door is. Actually, not really where the door is, but on that whole side there, I want to put an awning so that we pull up somewhere, we can open up the awning. We kind of have a porch area, you know, covered. We can pull bikes out and leave them under there and all that kind of good stuff. Got to figure out what kind of awning I want to get. I've been looking on Craigslist, Marketplace, stuff like that to see if I can find an awning that was used or something. If you guys have any suggestions, let me know. If you've dealt with manual versus electric or whatever. I'm thinking about going on manual one, but what I want to do is come up with a size, general size that I want. I probably want it pretty long to go the most of the width of that top part of the bus, and I'm going to go ahead and put some reinforcements in places on the bus, weld in some plate steel or something. Where I know they're at, that way I can drive bolts through it later and have a real secure mounting spot. So that'll help out. I've got to wire those Sasquatch lights on the outside. I've got a bunch of extra wiring from when I purchased the bus and he had pulled out all the wiring that he didn't need. I've got a whole bunch of that, so I'm just gonna probably use that. Haven't figured out. I'm gonna probably run some types of relays. I have a couple LED, you know, Sasquatch lights, I call them. I'm probably gonna get a couple more and figure out what wattage and output is, so I know what gauge wire to run in, even if I'm gonna run some type of relay on those. And then thinking about switching it, you know, might have it on a switch in the back in the bedroom, so I can kick on all the lights all at once, and then probably have one somewhere in the front of the bus too, maybe the driver's seat. I'll just do a three-way 12-volt switch, you know, each one having its own relay or something. We'll have to figure that out. So that's something I got to do. Exterior lights. Some of the exterior lights, the running lights on the inside, when we were framing, I had to cut some of the wires, so I just have to redo those wires. We framed around the front wheel well. We did that in this video, which was awesome, so we got that one knocked out. Frame around the rear lights for an access panel. So I'm going to frame around the rear lights. I've got some 2x3s to frame around there. That way, I've got access to them later. I'm not going to spray foam that area. I'll probably use some kind of wool insulation, something like that, to insulate back behind there. That way, I can always get to those wires. What else do I have here? Oh, I got to insulate and seal up the doghouse. I've got a bunch of weather stripping and stuff for that. Excuse me. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do on the inside of that doghouse box. If I want to do anything on the inside, I might just insulate it on the outside, maybe on the outside with spray foam, and then fiberglass over the spray foam, form it, mold it, sand it, make it something cool, and then fiberglass over it, the whole thing, just to try to deaden some of the sound and make the heat not pour out of my leg when I'm driving that thing, because that thing does put out some heat. But that doesn't really have to be done prior to spray foaming. So quite a big, I think, to-do list. The big one, the time-consuming one for me, is probably going to be the metal, because I got to weld up quite a few pieces. I do have all the measurements, though. Kai helped me calculate those out yesterday, so we know how much we need, what we're going to do. We're probably going to add another 24 feet of 1-inch square tubing, 1/8-inch thick, in some certain spots and weld it in place. And then also, just some future stuff. So I did find a tank. It's from Class A Customs. They're out of Ohio or something like that, maybe. Anyway, they custom make, or they make water tanks, RV tanks. The tanks that I found are 115 gallon or 125, I think is what they are, gallon. Pretty big, 64 inches long, 26 and a half wide, and 18 tall. So my idea is I was going to put them under the back bed, but now I'm actually going to put them underneath. On either side, in front, just in front of each of the rear wheels, one on each side, the gray tank. That's not the Rona, by the way. I got a bunch of allergies right now because somebody just cut the grass. So the gray tank is going to go on the left side, because that's where your pump out side is, and then I'm going to put the water tank on the right side, but then my fill port is going to be on the left side. So I think that should be pretty easy. What I'm going to do is take some angle iron, make some brackets to hold it all in place underneath, like they do on big trucks and stuff like that. And it should be more than enough adequate to support the weight of the water tanks. So that's the plan. Little by little, day by day, you know, I'm getting, I think, the to-do list knocked down shorter and shorter. It's quite a bit of work, but I think the boys are enjoying it. Kelly really hasn't got into it yet. She's still a little apprehensive about it, but I think once this stuff gets done, all the kind of framing and electrical and all that, I think she's going to have a lot of fun with the interior design and the cabinets and the wall coverings and stuff like that we're going to do. So, yep, guys, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.